Hello, Natalie here. Today I'm showing you how to create the seascape with a bit of a deeper meaning. These are the colors I'm using, a lot of different shades of reds. I don't often use reds, so that was something new for me. I chose these colors to create a painting inspired by the song 99 Luftballons, or in English 99 Red Balloons, by the German band Nena. As you maybe know, I grew up in Berlin and I heard that song the first time when I was like 6 or 7 years old in my parents' car. And although the song has a very dancey rhythm, it actually has a pretty sad story. And it made me ask my first questions back then about why there are wars, about the wars that happened in history, and if there's a danger that another war could start in Europe, and what would be ways to keep up peace. And now, with the devastating happenings in Ukraine, I remembered how I felt as a child when I first heard about such a thing as a war, feeling just as helpless about it all now. I chose the dump and swirl technique to make red dots symbolizing balloons appearing randomly in the sky area, just like the red balloons in the song appear suddenly in the summer sky. If you should not know the song, just look it up on YouTube and listen to it, both in the German and the English version, if you don't understand German. The German version is a little bit more on point, I think, but the English version gets the idea across as well. I gave this the setting of an oceanscape because even in hard times, the ocean and looking at the ocean always brings some peace to me and symbolizes the hope for a more peaceful future. Here you see me using different bluish-gray shades, mainly mixes of my paint drippings and some white, which is mixed with American Floater and a tiny bit of some wood stain to create some waveform lacing at the bottom part of this painting. There is actually a second painting to this 99 Red Balloons series, which can also be understood as part of a diptych. So this painting would then be the top panel and the other painting could hang right below it. I show you a picture of the second painting in the end. I don't have a video of how I made it. But the second painting is inspired by the last lines of the song, which are about the time after a big war when the world is destroyed, but there's finally peace again, and the protagonist of the song finds a single red balloon reminding her of the time before the war and lets it fly into the air. Of course, this is an abstract piece, so you can also find your own interpretation. Maybe the red dots in the sky are just traces of the sunset, and some of that red is reflecting on the gray ocean waves. Or whatever else you see in this, please let me know in the comments of what you think of this painting, what you think of the story I told you about it, and what you see. So here's the finished painting, and this is the other part to it, which might hang below it. So here you see it as a diptych, possibly. But both also work on their own, and you can actually currently see and buy them at Ingleside Gallery in San Francisco in their show called Visions for the Future. And I submitted that for the sub-theme Beyond the War Machine. Please come by if you're in the Bay Area. There's also a benefit auction for Ukraine on May 27th. You find links in the description box. Thank you for watching and see you next time.